Fitness fanatic, philanthropist, and entrepreneur Robin Ashdown launched her very own feminine sports apparel label as a platform for feminine empowerment. Now she joins me now in studio to share her incredible story. Robin, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
I'm very excited to touch base with you because South Africa already knows this about me, so it's no secret. I am lazy AF. So now it's so lovely to find someone who is fit AF, fit as femme. I mean, what encouraged you to start getting fit, getting healthy, and getting into your body?
So I've always been a fitness fanatic. I'm one of those weirdos that had health problems growing up. And, you know, I always had to be very conscious of what I was putting in my body. I did end up hurting my back very, very badly when I was in my late teens. And instead of going for a huge operation and destroying what I think was perfectly built, yeah. I had to find a way to turn my body into my own brace. So fitness became a very, very key function for me in order to be able to do a normal thing such as walking.
That decision as a kid must have been very difficult. I mean, having to decide what to do with your body going forward, that essentially is going to change the trajectory of your life. I mean, imagine if you had gone for that operation. It's crazy to think.
I was very fortunate. My mom was very conscious of, you know, what to do for to look after yourself. And I think it was a very important thing for her, for all of us to be aware of how we look after ourselves, how we exercise, how we look, how we treat our bodies. Mm. You know, because at the end of the day, we are blessings, all of us.
Yeah.
And we need to respect that. You know, respect your body, you're going to have a good life. That's really the way it works out in the long run.
Let's get into just your transitioning within the fitness world. I mean, you ended up going into weightlifting and. I mean, talk about an overachiever truly going the extra mile. I mean, so what was that all about and how did you get into that world?
So I actually started off as a kid, you know, your parents throw you into every activity, right? So I had netball, soccer, tennis, swimming and dancing. So dancing was just my absolute passion. I fell in love with it.
Yeah.
Here we go. See?
Little That's dancers awesome. Here connecting.
I fell in love with it and that was how I hurt my back. So the discovery phase of working through turning my body into my own brace, working with a bio, we were doing a lot of squats and lifting kettlebells and whatnot. And next thing he had me doing weightlifting exercises, recommended that I join a weightlifting gym.
Wow.
Yeah, so I started doing weightlifting and then I discovered CrossFit. So I kind of got the best of everything in one. Yeah, and you know.
Talk about truly pushing the limits of your body. So what are some of just the health benefits of having an active lifestyle, being and living within your body? I mean, how are people, especially just the average South African, able to connect with that and dramatically change their lives?
Honestly, I don't get sick. I don't ever really feel tired. One of those people that I get up at 4:30 in the morning, I'll go for a run, I'll exercise, get home, have my coffee, shower, change, and then only start work. And that's all before 8 a.m. You know, so I feel like I can always just keep going.
Yeah. So essentially, you know, you've got a boost in energy throughout the day. I can only imagine that immune system. You said you haven't been sick in a very long time.
No, even with COVID, you know, I've got underlying conditions in that I've got pernicious anemia, so my body doesn't absorb B12. You know, that makes your red blood cells, and that's what helps you heal.
That's what we need, B12, okay.
Yeah. But even having that, because I'm so, stringent around my fitness and maintaining my health, I haven't had any issues. Mm. I've been cautious and whatnot, but, you know, sitting here with you is fine for me. I'm quite comfortable with that because I know that I'm very, very healthy.
But now moving into the fashion side of it. So you said, you know what, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm a this, I'm a that, and also you're just all about empowering females. You decided to put your name on clothing and give us something feminine to kind of work out in.
100%, but also something comfortable and functional, right?
Very important. I want to get into the fashion then. Let's see it. Let's see what Robin has decided to put together for us as women working out, but I also know you do have something for the men too.
Yeah, we have a few secret things on our websites for the men. Some barbells as well, if they want to find those. But when it came to the female stuff, it's really, you know, trying to diversify. So we've got so many cultures in South Africa, right? If you look at our beautiful Muslim culture, you can't go to a gym in a nice pair of three quarters or shorts. They need the full length. So I wear the full length. They're actually my favorite, funny enough. You know, so we've got the full length options. We have the different types of styling on tops with different materials. A lot of the focus was making sure that it was comfortable for us. Because you're the one who's wearing it, right? Mm-hmm. So ensuring that the fit was there, the support is there, that the pants aren't riding up if you're wearing a pair of shorts.
Yes.
That they're not folding down.
That they're not folding down or rolling up. You have to have everything intact when you're working out.
Okay, well, also my theory is that if you could sit on a couch and lounge around all day in that, then you know it's going to be comfortable when you're training in it too. So it was really just trying to diversify that as much as possible. The materials as well, as I said. So the worst thing is when you do go to gym or you're wearing this pair of leggings and you do a squat, they become a bit transparent.
Oh, yes. That's also something that happens. Absolutely.
Yeah, quite often. So we spent a lot of time focusing on materials. And then, you know, with the design as well, the designs have been tweaked quite a few times to just make sure that they suit that comfort.
You seem to have almost something for everyone, from your hoodies, your crop tops, to those little, what do they call it, the racer bags.
Yeah.
I love that about you. I mean, what message do you have for anyone out there who wants to kind of diversify, not only diversify their brand, but just what they do on a daily basis and adding exercise and fitness into their routine?
So honestly, I believe that you're capable of anything. And in particular with females, we were born to be queens.
Yeah.
So for me, it's all about just embracing your power and accepting that. You know, you've got so much strength in you, and the first thing you got to do is just start.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, here's to starting, although we're not finished with you, because you're going to be putting me through my paces in a little bit of a workout little later. So South Africa, I mean, what an inspiration Robin Ashdown is to all of our viewers. And of course, a strong-willed woman who never allowed her physical and medical limitations stop her from achieving her goals and in the same time, starting a platform to empower others.